In part one of our series, we discussed the factors limiting steelhead populations in the East Fork Potlatch River, which included a lack of habitat complexity, increased water temperatures, and increases in fine sediment. In order to address these issues, we conduct stream restoration projects. This involves working with a landowner who is willing to let us do restoration on their property. Once we develop an agreement with the landowner, we start the process by working with a habitat engineer to design the project.
So one of my favorite things about what I do is working so closely with these fisheries scientists. And they call me when they know that there's an issue, and we get together and we start brainstorming. We talk about what's wrong in the system, what's not functioning correctly, and then how we can fix it. And so it's really a collaborative process between the fish biologists and the engineering, so I can design exactly what they want out here. So this is becoming more of a steelhead nursery by having these protected side channels with wood cover that brings in bugs and organic material, so the fish can just have a place to grow and get big before they have their journey to the ocean.
Based on the needs of the project, we use a variety of habitat restoration techniques to address the limiting factors that we discussed in part one of this video series. One of these main techniques is using large woody debris, which basically is putting whole trees into the stream. This serves several purposes, including creating habitat for the juvenile fish to hide, increases habitat complexity, it helps us push water into some of the old channels, and helps create new scour pools. This also helps us with what we call floodplain connectivity, and this is getting the water up out of the main channel and into old side channels and into the meadow. A meadow is like a big sponge. In the spring during flooding, that water goes out and soaks back into the meadow and then refills that sponge. And that happens every year, which then provides that water for the grasses to grow and for that water to then seep back into the spring as cooler water during the summer. So in this specific location, one thing that we can point out is this big log jam here behind us. This log jam we built specifically to help slow water down and to then push it into this other side channel over here. And that does a couple of things. Again, slowing the water down, but it also spreading that water out on the landscape more. Recharges the meadows better, provides a lot more habitat, and then as we can also see, there's a lot of nice scour here and a lot of gravel all over the stream bank in this area. Although it may look like this log jam has become a permanent barrier, there's still a lot of spaces through there that the fish can get through. Another technique we use is to construct new riffles, which helps raise the water level and push it into some of these old channels. As you can see, the big riffle that we constructed here has created this large pool that has backed that water up and created the pool, which is then pushing the water in front of me here down this side channel. And so the water is actually flowing this way into the side channel with Fry Creek coming in, and then all that water going down the side channel and reconnecting to the East Fork of the Potlatch a few hundred meters downstream. In addition to pushing water into old side channels, another technique that we use is constructing completely new side channels, as we have with this one here in front of me. The idea is just to create additional habitat and additional floodplain connectivity in some cases like this where we don't have enough original side channels on site. In spring during high water, this will be completely full, which helps spread that water out.
After the construction, we replant a lot of the native shrubs and grasses to revegetate some of the areas that may have been disturbed by equipment. And this is very important because this revegetation helps address limiting factors. As you can see here, there's a lot of vegetation regrowing along this project that we completed in 2021. As you look around, you can see a lot of native grasses as well as some willows and alders. In the short term, the vegetation helps to prevent erosion and sediment going back into the stream, which is something that's not very good for the fish. In the long term, as they grow, the plants will provide a lot of shade and also cooler temperatures for the juveniles. And when they grow big enough and eventually die, they'll fall into the stream and provide more cover for the juveniles, as well as some cover for insects, which the juveniles eat.
All of these components of a project, such as adding large wood, reconnecting the floodplain, and planting vegetation, all contribute to improving the habitat complexity of this area, which in turn then helps improve the survival and growth of juvenile steelhead in the East Fork Potlatch River.
We're really excited about the work we're doing on the East Fork of the Potlatch River, as we think it will make a significant difference for this iconic Idaho fish.
Our ability to implement these restoration projects is dependent on private landowners allowing us to work on their property. In part three of our series, we discuss the importance of building relationships with landowners, and you'll hear several landowners explain why these projects are important to them.